So the topic of our presentation and the topic of the meeting is the age of speed. So we've entitled the presentation today, The Art of Communication in the Age of Speed. And really it's about how Domenico and I communicate together to get these sort of results that we were trying to achieve, like what you see on the screen today. And I think that one of the reasons that Domenico and I see eye to eye and we have a good communication is probably because we're about the same height and we can see eye to eye on a lot of things. So in relation to speed, I think it's important to try and deliver restorations in a timely manner and give our patients what they want when we promise that they're going to be delivered. But I think it's also important not to bypass a lot of the important steps, particularly in prosthodontics, because we're restorative dentists and Domenico's a technician, because if we do that, we're going to fall into a trap where we're going to have restorations that are probably going to fail or are going to be unsatisfactory for a patient. So we're sharing with you our experience and how we've developed some techniques or modified some other techniques to try and develop ways to improve efficiency of the delivery of patient treatment. And that brings us to the first patient treatment that we have for you. It's a patient who saw a dentist, I think had some implant training at a weekend near the airport, and he immediately started to do some implant dentistry on the patient and tried to deliver what you call an all-on-four type of dentistry. I'm being facetious, but really when you look at this patient and look at the initial situation, may I take the liberty of asking how long you think this restoration was in the patient's mouth when he presented to me with complaints? How many years? 2 years? 50 years. It looks like it's aged a lot. I mean, a lot of, but in actual fact, this patient had this restoration only for 4 months before he showed up at my in my office. And when you take a look at this photograph, you may think that I'm a bad photographer because I went to SC, PROS. But in actual fact, I do think I'm a good photographer. And the reason there's a tissue left in the photograph when I took the picture on the left is because the patient presented that way. He had tissue in the mouth in order to function. It kept his cheek puffed out so his face didn't look collapsed, and it stops him from biting his cheeks. And look at these abutments. They're really, really rough. They're a magnet for plaque and bacteria, all the things our periodontists hate. And look at the position of those implants. They are apical to the mucogingival junction. So every time his lip moves, we're going to get some discomfort. And that's what